Hello everyone, welcome back to Viresh tutorial. In this video I will be dealing with the pest surveillance. Before going to the pest surveillance, let us understand pest survey. Pest survey means insect pests which appear regularly or sometimes those which are introduced to a new area. The monitoring of those pests is of great help in order to check their population. So the monitoring can be done through a process called as pest survey. Pest survey means it is a planned procedure conducted over a defined period of time to determine the characteristics of the pest population occur in an area. Characteristics of a pest population means how the pest population is increasing or decreasing in an area. For example, fall armyworm is a recently introduced pest or invasive pest to India, distributed in different states of the country, which is monitoring through the pest survey. Survey can be done by two ways. One is a roving survey, second one is fixed plot survey. In a roving survey, assessment of pest population or damage can be done for general pest status over a large area within a short period of time. If you'd like to know the pest status irrespective of the pest species in a larger area, we will go for this type of survey. For example, to know the status of wheat and mustard pests in North India, then we will go for roving survey. Roving survey means it will be done for general pest status over a large area within a short span of time. In a fixed plot survey, the assessment of pest population or damage can be done for specific pest from a fixed plot selected in a field. The data on the pest population recorded periodically from sowing till harvesting. Suppose if you'd like to know the pest status of a specific pest in a specific area, then we will go for fixed plot survey. For example, total number of tillers affected by stem borer in Ludhiana district of Punjab. Either in a roving survey or in a fixed plot survey, the sampling of the pest population is depending upon the type of damage that they are going to cause. And sampling is also depending upon what are you looking for, either at the absolute count of the pest or at the damaged plant parts. There are two types of sampling methods. One is block survey methodology and second one is point survey methodology. Let's see the block survey methodology. Over an area, we are going to select certain blocks of a fixed size, say 1 by 1 meter. In 1 by 1 meter area, we are going to count total number of healthy plants and total number of affected plants to calculate percent of plants affected based on the damaging symptoms. In a point survey methodology, we are going to select 20 plants randomly in an area. From each plant, we will be recording number of insect pests or affected plant parts. If you do this type of survey repeatedly at a fixed intervals over a period of time, then that will be called as surveillance. Pest surveillance refers to the constant monitoring of the pest population dynamics, its incidence and damage on each crop at a regular intervals to forewarn the farmers to take up control measures. In a simple words, the regular surveys of the same place or locality at a consistent intervals to assess changes in the pest species over a period of time. That is called as pest surveillance. Why pest surveillance is important? To know the existing and invasive pest status of the country, to estimate crop losses caused by different insect pests in different agriculture ecosystem, to assess the pest population and damage at different growth stages of a crop, to study the influence of weather parameters on the pest population, and to study the changing of pest status from minor to major as well as major to minor with a change in the cropping pattern, to monitor development of biotypes, resistance and resurgence in a particular ecosystem, to assess the natural enemies and their influence on pest population, and to estimate the effect of new cropping pattern and varieties on the pest population dynamics. Directorate of Plant Protection, Quarantine and Storage, DPPQS, is located at Faridabad, is organizing regular surveys on major field crops in different agro ecosystems in collaboration with ICAR and SAUs to monitor pest population on different crops. Few ICAR and SAUs have developed e-pest surveillance system. In this system, the data will be collected by the pest scout in the field, and the data will be sent it to the pest monitor for the verification, and then the same data will be uploaded to the computer by the computer operator, and it will go to the particular database survey, and then the data will be processed. The processed data will be verified by the experts, and then pest advisory fed into the system by the experts. And pest advisory given by the experts is viewed by the State Department officials, and then advisory dispersed to the farmers through SMS by the State Department officials. What are all the problems associated with the pest surveillance? The advisories given by the experts is covering only limited area and reaching less number of farmers. There is no convergence in data of surveillance by multiple agencies. And authenticity or reliability of the data is a major problem, and there is no accurate station for early warning of the pest status at each district and state. If you have specific doubts on this chapter, please mention in the comments. Thank you.